Information age is most definitely upon us, and it's upon our children, whether we like it or not. The world is changing so rapidly, it's impossible to keep up. Change is inevitable, but the rate of change we see now is unprecedented. How we talk to one another has changed. Where we find information has changed. How we work, how we shop, how we meet, how we date. It has all changed. And because of all this change, one other thing must change. How we protect our children. We've seen tragedy and despair around the world and thought, that could never happen here. But the world is now one mouse click away, one text away, and there's no avoiding it. The world has gotten smaller. We have access to anything, anytime, anywhere. But it has access to us and to our children.
So, what can you do? Where do you begin? How do you learn about the risks your children are facing every day? And how do you possibly keep up? You start with your child. You stay with your child. And you learn with your child. Remember that everything you do to protect your child's online experiences will help. And everything you do starts with communication.
Despite the ever-changing landscape of the online world, the offline world still holds a tried and true location for starting the conversation: the dinner table. Take this daily opportunity to develop and maintain the kind of relationship that will help keep your child safe on the internet and help you learn more about the online world where your children communicate and learn. When you ask them what they learned at school today, follow up with another question. What did you learn online today? Ask them to show you the latest funny video on YouTube. Learn new emoticons, new acronyms, new online friends. The more open you are about learning their world, the more open your child will be about letting you in.
Filters, software, text monitoring, and other safety precautions all help, and you should explore them. But the truth is, the technology is always changing, and that means there's always a way around the restrictions. Conversation, however, keeps the lines open and allows you to understand the online world and how to look for possible concerns. Try these questions and see what you learn. What are your favorite things to do online? What would you do if anyone online asked to meet you face to face? Besides me, whom do you feel that you can talk to if you are in a scary or uncomfortable situation?
Keep the lines open. Keep the questions coming. Keep the involvement active. Google Internet Safety for Children. Ask your children's teachers and counselors for suggestions. Talk with other parents and compare notes. And keep on trying. The online threats are real, and everyone who is online is exposed to them. But the solutions are real too. And they begin with you.